Experts we spoke to say when an electric vehicle catches on fire, it's attention-grabbing for a few reasons. One, EVs are still relatively new, and people have questions about their risks. And two, EV fires burn in such a way that's hard to miss.
On the side of a highway, a white Tesla ignites. Firefighters get to work, propping up the car's back wheels to concentrate water on the lithium-ion battery underneath.
Do you feel like fire departments across the state have the tools to deal with these types of fires?
No, I don't think so. I mean, other than the water, that's it. That's all we got.
Maryland State Fire Marshal Brian Geraci says when the lithium-ion battery in an electric vehicle ignites, it's especially dangerous.
These things fail very quickly, and they give off a tremendous amount of heat and tremendous amount of fire. There's an explosion hazard as well with these things.
The biggest problem, when the fire moves beyond one cell, meaning it spreads to the rest of the battery, setting off a dangerous chain reaction called thermal runaway.
When a battery goes into thermal runaway, they will generate their own heat and they will propagate, or they will move from cell to cell to cell to cell. And these batteries can get over 1,000 degrees.
But wait a second, let's rewind.
Though experts say an electric vehicle fire is dangerous, is it more likely to happen than a fire in a gas-powered car?
Probably when you really crunch the numbers, proportionally, probably less. But certainly they're not more prevalent than a gas-powered vehicle fire.
I totally agree with that. Gas vehicles, we're having fires every single day. The electric vehicles are few and far between.
Mike Hoover went through extensive training in order to become the electric vehicle specialist at Tim's Automotive and Towing in Parkville.
So we have to use linesman gloves. These are the same gloves that the linesmen use on the high power lines. They're rated up to 1,000 volts.
But even though working on EVs requires specialized tools, Hoover says electric vehicles are less likely to catch fire. But you don't need to take Hoover's word for it.
We've had a few electric car fires, but not that many. It's usually when they're in a collision or something like that, or when the batteries are damaged.
And the fire marshal now has data to back it up. His office started tracking all lithium-ion battery fires back in April, providing the first and only public data on electric vehicle fires and other types of electric fires that exist statewide. With more than 6 months of data from every fire department across the state, so far there's only been one electric vehicle fire. But Geraci says it's a different story for gas-powered cars.
We've already had, I believe, up to 10 deaths already due to collisions with fires this year in the state of Maryland, so where people have died in their cars.
Besides when a battery is damaged in a crash, Geraci, Rustkowski, and Hoover say doing these things are key in avoiding electric vehicle fires. Use the factory-supplied charger, plug your car into the wall, don't use extension cords, and follow the owner's manual instructions.
Geraci says he hopes the website will provide transparency about which types of lithium-ion battery fires are and are not common. Coming up tomorrow at 5, the fire marshal's data shows e-bikes and electric scooters, which are also powered by these batteries, are a more significant fire risk. The experts explain why, and I'll show you the special equipment being used by fire departments locally to put them out. For 11 News Investigates, I'm Tali Taylor.